Today on the workshop, we're going to be going old school, going back to a Tom Daniel design. The reissued Revell Rommel's Rod is back out in 2018, and we're going to build it up. This is in 1/24th scale, so it'll be a hair bigger, but since it's a parody vehicle or a comedy, a non-real vehicle, kind of based off of a real vehicle, we don't have to worry about exact scale or exact details or anything. Here's a big pile of plastic that comes in the kit. You can see the nice Spartan interior that it has on the half track. You can see that nice convertible cover there, which we can paint. It's even got some seams in it there from the folded fabric look. We got the nice half track. That is a large size vehicle. As you can see, makes for a nice size kit. Gives us a lot of room for weathering and details. So we'll take a look at all of that. We're going to be beating this one up a little bit, but not totally destroying it. There's our chassis. This kit has been built many times by many modelers. I've never built it, so this will be my chance at giving it my touch. There's part of our engine, transmission, drivetrain. There's that big motor there. And the hood. The motor is ripe for extra details if you wanted to do so. Here we've got our skeletons. As you can see, they're just kind of characters of a skeleton for basic detail with boots. We've got our nice heads there. And we've got seats and other molded in details, little trenching shovels. We've got some machine guns here. We've got the bottom of our engine. We've got our front wheels. We've got the sides of our hood. We've got headlight covers. On here, we've got our spare tire with cover. We've got more small parts, fuel tanks, front suspension, windshield frames. On this one, we have the hat and head of Sir Rommel himself. And one of the arms is laying in the parts box, so I didn't show that one. But you can see the nice detail on the binoculars. These character kits, these parody kits, are always a blast because you don't have to worry about accuracy and no one can say you did something wrong. While you're looking at those other parts out there, I'll block your vision with the nice decals. Those are all on there. We've got the nice vinyl coated tires. Those look just fine. We can dirty those up. We've got the nice glass. I'll leave in there till I'm all done. And then we've got a chrome tree with some nice details on there that we can either paint over or black wash, whatever you choose. I love the hood ornament. Check that out. That is absolutely sweet. All right, time for a parts wash. We'll be back for a subassembly show off. Looking at what I have assembled so far, you can see it goes together really nice. I'm about 90 minutes, an hour and a half into the build, and now I'm going to start throwing paint on everything. First thing I'm going to do is cover the whole thing with black primer, except for the small remaining chrome accents that I haven't attached yet. Those will be flat coated with a matte acrylic, but the tracks, the spare tire which has been glued together, the wheel backs, the gas tanks, the ammo boxes, all the seats, the spare tracks, the shovel, the hood, which you can see goes on very nicely. Everything lines up really nice, no issues. I did glue the sides of the hood on after I had the engine in just to make sure it all fits. You can see that the engine fits in very well. There are two exhaust pipes that go through the fender that look really nice. This one's longer, so it'll sit in there on its own friction. The shorter one keeps falling off, so that's on the side so I can paint it. But I did want to show you so you can see how those go in there. And they'll just push free. And you can actually, of course, now they're going to hold together so good that I can't get it apart. But the engine will pull out, so you can put it in and out as you paint it. That's nicely detailed. That'll get all black coated. I'm not worried about any chrome on the engine whatsoever, so I just assembled it as it is. The interior comes out very nicely. To glue the windshields in, just place your interior in and then glue your windshields in place. Then you can remove it and your rear windshield will stay in place. Your front windshield will stay exactly where it should, which is glued in there with absolutely no seam line there at all. Fits in beautiful for a kit this age. You got your front roller, you got your lights in, upper and lower. We've got our figures assembled. Check those guys out. We got Rommel holding his binoculars, and we got the driver reaching up for the steering wheel. And he's real thin, so when we get him in the cab, all I have to do is hit him with a heat gun, and he will form those hands right around the steering wheel or as close as possible. So I'm going to get a coat of black primer on everything, And then we'll come back when I start getting some other colors and lay a base coat on. The reason I'm going with black on this one is because I want to have some shadows underneath my yellowish layer. We'll see you in a minute. Getting quite a bit of work done here. I did lay some paint down. What I did was I primed everything black, as we discussed. Everything got hit with black pretty much, and then started working. Now the chrome, all I did was dull coat that with a flat mat and then black wash the grill. I gotta dust that up a little bit. The wheels we have painted and chipped and scratched, you can see. Now the color of paint I used to replicate German yellow is a Krylon Wild Oats Matte. Just like so, and that paint dries relatively quick. I've got the hood painted. I still need to chip that up a little bit. Speaking of chipping, I've been getting a lot of it done on the body itself. You can see I've done a lot of chip effects on there. How do I do chip effects? I literally chip the paint. I just take my fingernail and I do little scratches on it all over. And I do a little chipping and scratching and chipping and scratching and work my way all the way around the vehicle, all the way around the floorboards, in the interior, on the exterior, on the edges of items, exactly where you think things would get chipped. That's where I do it. Now I've been working on a lot. I still have to do the hood. As you can see, goes together nice. There's quite a bit of work left to do. I just wanted to show you the parts I've been working on. I painted the seat a leathery color and then black washed it. These side tanks I wanted to do as little water tanks or whatnot, so then I just made leather straps on them, painted them gray, black washed them, beat them all up. Got our black antenna. We've got our chrome skull. Now all I have to do is paint the skeleton face on that with a little bit of off-white paint, and that's done. The exhaust, how did I rust up the exhaust nicely? Well, what I did was I hit it with the black primer, and then I just squirted red primer from quite a distance at it, and that gave me that nice chippy rusty look. The tracks on the back of the body are done in a metallic Tamiya paint. Okay, it's just a gunmetal paint, and those have to be a little bit beat up. These were supposed to be ammo boxes, I'm assuming, in the area where Rommel is. I wanted to do them as if he's carrying a cargo, so I did a gray with a metal strap over it. We've got our ammo box for the rear machine gun with our bullets blackwashed. We've got our tracks done up, and I just need to wash and weather them and beat them up even more. All I did so far was apply some Panaline wash to the interior of them so that we can see the actual spokes of each wheel. And those look pretty cool as is. Those are all done in the factory color and then black. We have to dry brush them and everything. We've got our shovel all painted up. What else we got? We've got the engine painted. You can see I primed it black, then sprayed the yellow over the top of it, because the engine, you know, obviously would have been body color. I don't really care. It's a fantasy vehicle. I wanted to do it in the body color. Now I have to oil it and get some grease and some rust staining on it with washes. We've got the steering wheel done up. I did spray paint the chrome black and left the center shiny. I want that to look sort of like a Bakelite plastic wheel, which it does come out looking like one very nicely. We've got our flags painted. All those need are the decals. And we've got our interior shift levers painted. I painted those black again so they look like Bakelite. The machine guns were sprayed black and then hit with a gunmetal to look like chipped and beat up and used metal. Remember, he's supposed to be a skeleton in this one. And there are the two skeletons. Those are painted up, ready to go. They've got future floor polish on the boots and their helmets to make them look leathery, shinier paint. And then we just blackwash those creepy faces. We did a whole black primer over the skeletons and then a Tamiya Racing White on there. Now, normally I do a more natural bone color. I wanted these guys to be more of a bright white skeleton look, and they look pretty awesome. We've got his field glasses on there, all painted up. We've got his gold Eagle Crest done. We're just waiting for that floor polish to dry on their leather boots and their leather hat and steel helmet. So those are ready to go. We're just going to leave those to the side for the rest of the build. I'm going to keep working on stuff before I do the final assembly and weathering. We'll be back for another look. All that's left now is to start putting all the pieces and parts together. We've got the body worked over. We've got the engine grimed up and installed. You can see that sweet rusted exhaust going down through there. We got all the paint scratches and chips. Of course, because this is a character kit, I wanted to over-accentuate the chips and the beat-upness, make it really look like the Allies, Mr. Patton there, General Patton, had just beaten the heck out of them, and they're running for their lives. What I did change on the kit was one thing. They have you installing some night blocks on the headlights or the fog lights. I installed little clear bulbs on the headlights. They're not lit up, but I just installed some self-adhesive clear plastic on the fog lights so I could get that look of, you know, how Christine, the ghost vehicle, shines its lights super bright. I wanted to put those in there, and I didn't have ones large enough to go where the Maltese crosses were on the bigger headlights, so I just left the fog lights exposed. The bigger ones have that cool Maltese cross on there. So we've got all the decals on. I smudged around each decal to make it look like they had tried to cover them up a little bit, hide who they were at first when they were running, smear them over so they couldn't see the emblems, and we got that big Mercedes inline 8 under the hood doing all its work. We've got the interior ready to go. He's got his grenades on the passenger seat, his shift lever, and he's all grimed up and dusted up inside. The skeletons, of course, were ready to go for quite a while, so we don't need to look at those again. I've got the glass clear coated with Future so I can glue that in. We've got those tracks weathered up really nice, metallic over rust. Those look great. A lot of dry brushing. We've got the wheels and tires dusted up and beat up with a little bit of burnt sienna rubbed in it to look like grime. We've got the flags all set up, ready to go in the front, glued together. We've got our hood all beat up, all weathered and scratched. So all I have to do now is assemble all the parts. I'll even let you look at the cool hood ornament. Check out the detail on that. Painted with skeleton bone and then washed with a dark color wash from Army Painter. That looks amazing. That's going to get glued on very last thing. I'm going to assemble all the pieces and parts, give it one more dust coating with some tile grout, and we'll come back for the final. And Rommel's Rod is all done. Check out this awesome kit. It just goes together nicely. What I did was apply a final dry brushing and some more dust effects. We toned down those chips so that they look covered over. We toned down the decals by using the dry brushing and some dust effects. Look faded, look a little covered up, a little dusty. We've got the machine gun in the back. We've got extra tracks in the back to protect Rommel from behind. We've got the beautiful half track itself with tools and equipment boxes. It's just an excellent kit all the way around. This thing has been around since the 60s and is re-released again this year, so you can build it and pick it up. It's by Revell. It's in 1/24th scale, being an old monogram kit. They used to love that scale size. Even though this kit is old and a reproduction, it still goes to, I mean, it just falls together. It's really, really nice. Now, you'll notice that I dusted up everything. I kind of beat everything up. The only thing that I did not dust up and not beat up, kind of as a ghost effect, how does it happen, was I left the hood ornament completely polished up and clean. I just like that it kind of shines up there with the skull in it. We got the two skeletons driving it. I posed the driver's arm, one on the windshield and one up on the machine gun. Looked a little more nemesis menacing that way, and then I dirtied up the glass like that. I didn't apply any wiper marks. Doesn't have any wipers here. It has small ones in the front only. But Rommel looks great on the back there. It's an excellent kit. You get Fantasy Hot Rod by Tom Daniel, which are always fun. You get a military vehicle, a World War II vehicle you get to decorate. And it's not a real vehicle. It's fantasy, so you really can't make any mistakes with it. We can still, if we're careful while it spins here, we can get that hood off. You can see that big inline Mercedes 8-cylinder. Beautiful engine. I greased it all up, rusted it up, rusted out those manifolds coming off underneath the fender there. It's just an excellent kit, and I had a real good time building it. Definitely a suggestion. You can pick these kits up for around a 20 spot. Just Google Revell Rommel's Rod. Right there is the name, and you'll find it easily online. Thanks for watching the workshop. This is the last kit review for 2018. We've done 60 some model builds in 2018 together, and we hope to do just as many in 2019. We'll see you at the next review.